Hello students, you are watching IAC Mathematics and we are solving the exercise 14A of chapter Equation of a Straight Line. In the last class we have solved the question till question number 11. Now let us solve question number 12 onwards. Okay, question number 12. We are given coordinates of point A and B. Okay, we have to find the gradient and the equation. Gradient means find the slope and equation of line passing through the given point. Clear? So now we know how to find the gradient or slope. We have a formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. We will find out the slope of line AB denoted by m is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Okay, x1, y1 are the coordinates of A, x2, y2 are the coordinates of B. Therefore, m is equal to y2 is minus 4 minus 1 upon x2 is 3 minus minus plus 2. Therefore, m is equal to minus 5 upon 5 and therefore m is minus 1, that is slope of line AB is minus 1. Now, if you want to find the equation of a line, then we can use the point slope formula. So, slope is given. Now, which point to take? We are given two points on the required line. A and B both are the points line 1, line AB. So, you can consider any one point we should take, either A or B. Let me take A. Okay, so now we will write down that equation of a line having slope. Okay, what is slope? Minus 1 and passing through point A minus 2, 1. Remember that you can take even point B. It is not compulsory to take A. We can even take point B in place of A. Yes or no? Actually, you can take any point given on the line. Here we are given two points, so you can select any one point out of the two points. Clear? So we will put this formula. Okay. What is the formula, point slope formula? It is given by y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now we know that the value of m is minus 1 and x1, y1 are the coordinates of point A. So let us substitute. Now y minus 1 is equal to m is minus 1 into x minus minus plus x plus 2. Therefore y minus 1 is equal to minus x minus 2. Therefore x plus y minus 1 plus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore x plus y plus 1 is equal to 0. So this is the required equation of line AB. Clear? So I hope you have understood this. Since we are told to find the slope and the equation, so first we will calculate the slope using the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. After you get m, you can use this formula y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now x1, y1 can be the coordinates of point A or point B. Yes or no? So you can consider any one point, okay, to put the values in the given formula. Clear? If you were not given to find the slope, in that case we can use the two point formula. Recall that formula, it is given by y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. We can directly use that formula in case you are told to find only the equation of a line. Yeah? But here, since we are told to calculate first slope, so we have calculated first slope and then we have used point slope formula. Okay, so now second of question number 12, A 4 minus 2, this is x plus y क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 x प्लस y प्लस 1 एंड माइनस 1 ओके नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 सेकंड वन a 4 माइनस 2 एंड b 2 माइनस 3 आर गिवन कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ पॉइंट a आर गिवन 4 माइनस 2 एंड कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ पॉइंट b आर गिवन टू बी 2 माइनस 2 कॉमा माइनस 3 ओके सो अगेन द सेम मेथड ओके फर्स्ट वी विल कैलकुलेट द स्लोप सो स्लोप ऑफ लाइन AB डिनोटेड बाय m इज इक्वल टू y2 माइनस y1 अपॉन x2 माइनस x1 therefore m is equal to y2 is minus 3 minus minus 2 upon 2 minus 4 minus 3 plus 2 upon minus 2 minus 1 upon minus 2 therefore m is 1 by 2 so we got the slope to be 1 by 2 now equation of line having slope 1 by 2 and passing through point A 4 comma minus 2 again we will use the point slope formula So what is the formula? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Therefore, y minus minus 2, that is y plus 2, is equal to m is 1 upon 2 x minus 4. Let us simplify. We'll multiply 2 on the left side. So 2y plus 4 is equal to x minus 4. Therefore, 2y minus x plus 8 is equal to 0 or x minus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0 this is the required equation of line AB clear okay now let us solve question number 13 Okay, point P and Q. Point P having coordinate minus 1 comma 4 and Q having coordinate 5 comma minus 2. Minus 1 comma 4, 5 comma minus 2 are given. Okay, it intersects x and y axis at points A and B respectively, and M is the midpoint of AB. We have to find the equation of line. PQ coordinates of A and B and the coordinates of M. Okay, now first we have to question 13 contains three parts. Number one, we have to find the equation of line PQ. Since you are given the coordinates of two points, we can use the 2-point formula. Okay, so let us calculate using the formula equation of line PQ. Equation of line PQ will be given by y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Here x1, y1 are the coordinates of P and x2, y2 are the coordinates of Q. Okay, so let us put the values in the formula y minus 4 upon x minus minus 1 that is plus 1 is equals to minus 2 minus 4 and 5 plus 1. Therefore, y minus 4 upon x plus 1 is equal to minus 6 by 6. Y minus 4 upon x plus 1 is equal to minus 1. And therefore, y minus 4 is equal to minus x minus 1. And therefore, x plus y minus 3 will be equal to 0. This is the first answer. Okay, this is the equation of line PQ. Okay, now second thing. Second question is given that this line PQ intersects x and y axis in points A and point B. Okay, now whenever you want to find the intercept made by any line on the coordinate axis, so we will follow this procedure. Number one, if you want to find the x intercept in the given equation, we will put y is equal to 0. Why? Because we know that on x axis y coordinate is always 0, and therefore in equation 1 we will put y is equal to 0. Now we will write that on x axis y is equal to 0. Yes or no? Therefore substituting y is equal to 0 in equation 1. Substituting y is equal to 0 in equation 1. What is equation 1? X plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Let us put y is equal to 0. Therefore x minus 3 is equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to 3. So we got the x intercept. Okay, now x intercept means the coordinates of point A we got 3, 0. Yes or no? Therefore, coordinates of A, since A is a point on x axis, the line PQ cuts x axis in point A. Yes or no? So, coordinates of point A will be 3, 0. Therefore, coordinates of A will be 3, 0. Clear? Now similarly we will find out the coordinates of B. Now B is a point of intersection of y axis and line PQ. So on y axis what should we write? Just like we wrote that on x axis y is 0, similarly on y axis x will be 0. So we will write down now on y axis x is equal to 0, and therefore we have x, substituting x is equal to 0 in equation 1, x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Put x is equal to 0, so y minus 3 is equal to 0, or y is equal to 3. It means the coordinates of point B will be 0, 3. So that we will write down. Okay, therefore the coordinates of point B are 0, 3. Clear? So this is answer number 2. Okay, now the third answer. It is given that M is the midpoint of AB. Line AB, we got the coordinates A and B. This is point A, 3, 0, and this is point B, 0, 3. M is the midpoint of AB. Now, M is the midpoint of AB. We have A, 3, 0, and B, 0, 3. So we have formula to find out the coordinates of the midpoint. In the previous chapter, section and midpoint formula, we have seen this formula. So therefore coordinates of M, x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, y is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2, therefore x is equal to 3 by 2 and y is equal to 3 by 2 and therefore coordinates of m will be 3 by 2 comma 3 by 2. Therefore, coordinates of m will be 3 by 2 comma 3 by 2. Clear? So, this is the third answer. So, this was question number 13 we have completed. Now, let us solve the next question, that is question number 14. I hope you have understood this question very well. Okay, let us solve question number 14 now. Question number 14. Okay, point A having coordinates 2, comma 3 and B having coordinates minus 2, comma 5 are given. The gradient of AB, equation of AB and coordinates of point where AB intersects x-axis. It is similar and simple question. Number 1, we have to find the gradient. Gradient means slope of AB and then equation of AB. Okay, so this thing we have done previously in question number 12. First, we will calculate the gradient of AB or slope of AB denoted by M is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Therefore, M is equal to x1, y1 are the coordinates of A and x2, y2 are the coordinates of B. So y2 is 5 minus 3 upon minus 2. Therefore m is equal to 2 upon minus 4 and therefore m is equal to minus 1 upon 2. This is the slope. Okay, now we will, since we have a slope and we can take any one point, okay, out of A and B to use the formula. Which formula shall we use? That is point slope formula. One point we will select, either A or B, and we have a slope M, which is minus 1 upon 2. So now equation of AB, equation of line AB, okay, having slope minus 1 by 2 and passing through point A 2 comma 3 will be given by y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Obviously m is minus 1 upon 2 and x1 y1 are the coordinates of point A. So y minus 3 is equal to minus 1 upon 2 into x minus 2. Therefore 2y minus 3 to the 6 is equal to minus x plus 2. Therefore x plus 2y minus 6 minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore x plus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0. Okay, this is the answer number 2. Okay, we got the slope of AB, we got the equation of AB. Now in the third question, we have to find the coordinates of the point where AB intersects x-axis. Okay, so that we have done previously, yes or no? Will you find the point where this line cuts x-axis? You know that on x-axis y coordinate will be 0, so we will put y is equal to 0. Okay, so third point, we will write down that on x-axis y is equal to 0, and therefore substituting y is equal to 0 in equation 1, let us number this equation as equation number 1. Okay, therefore x plus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0, therefore x minus 8 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 8. Okay, so we got the value of x, what is that? 8. So what will be the point on the x-axis where this line intersects x-axis? That will be 8, 0. So we will write down the final statement over here. Therefore, point on x-axis is 8, 0. 8, 0 is the point on the x-axis where the line 1 or line AB intersects x-axis. Clear? So, now make it very clear in your mind. If any line cuts the coordinate axis, then to find the point on x-axis, you will always put y is equal to 0. And to find the point on the y-axis, you will always put x is equal to 0 in the equation of the given line. Clear? Good. So question number 14 is over. Now we will solve the next question, that is question number 15. Okay, let us solve now question number 15. Okay, a straight line is passing through points A and B. Coordinates are given. Coordinates of point A are 2, -4, and coordinates of point B are 5, -2. We have to find the slope of AB, equation of AB, and the value of K if the line AB passes through a given point P. Coordinates of P are given. Here number 1, what you have to find? Slope of line AB. Now you are familiar with the formula of calculating the slope, that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So let us calculate the slope of AB. M will be given by y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Therefore, M is equal to y2 minus 2 minus minus plus 4 upon x2 is 5 minus 2. Therefore, M is equal to 2 upon 3. Okay, this is the slope of line AB. Now we will calculate the equation. So we have slope and we can consider any one point out of A or B. Yes or no? Now equation of a line having slope 2/3 and passing through point A 2, -4 will be given by the point slope formula. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, and therefore y minus x1 y1 will be the coordinates of point A. Yes or no? So y minus y1 minus minus plus 4 is equals to 2 upon 3 into x minus 2 multiply 3 on the left side. Therefore 3y plus 12 is equals to 2x minus 4. Therefore 3y minus 2x plus 16 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 3y minus 16 is equal to 0. This is the equation of line AB. Yes or no? This is the equation of line AB. This is the second answer. Now we are given a point P which lies on the line AB. Okay, earlier we have discussed this. If any point lies on the given line, then its coordinate will satisfy the equation. Now what do we mean that the coordinate satisfy the equation? So if point P lies on the given line, then the x coordinate of point P we can substitute for x, and y coordinate of P we can substitute for y in the given equation. Clear? So let us proceed now. Okay, point P. Okay, coordinates of point P are given k plus 3, k minus 4, k plus 3, comma k minus 4. Now this point P lies on line AB. Yes or no? Okay, now as I told, point P lies on line AB. It means for x axis, x code x variable x in the given equation, we will put k plus 3, x coordinate of P, and for y we will put k minus 4. Clear? And simplify so that we will get the value of k. So let us do that. Okay, now substituting coordinates of point P in equation 1. Substituting coordinates of point P in equation 1. What is equation 1? 2x minus 3y minus 16 is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Let us put now 2 into k plus 3 minus 3 into k minus 4 minus 16 is equal to 0. Now we will simplify. 2k plus 6 minus 3k plus 12 minus 16 is equal to 0. 2k minus 3k will be minus k. 12 minus 16 minus 4. 6 plus 6 minus 4 plus 2 is equal to 0, and therefore we will get 2k is equal to 2. Clear? If you take minus k on the right side, we get 2 is equal to k, or k is equal to 2. So this is the third answer, the value of k. So I hope you have understood this question number 15 in a proper way. Yes or no? Now let us solve question number 16. Question number 16 has two parts. Question number 16. Okay, in question number 16, we are given the coordinates of the vertices of triangle ABC. Let us write down the vertices. A has coordinate, this is first one of question number 16. has coordinates 3, 4, B has coordinates 7, minus 2, and C has coordinates minus 2, minus 1. Okay, we have to find the equation of the median through vertex C. Okay, ABC are vertices of triangle ABC. ABC minus 2, minus 1, 3, 4, 7 and minus 2. So three vertices of triangle ABC are given. You have to find the equation of the median through vertex C. Okay, so we will draw a median. Say CD is a median through vertex C on AB. Now we know what is the median. Median is a line segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the opposite side. Yes or no? So vertex C and midpoint on the of the opposite side, that is AB. So D is the midpoint of AB. Clear? Median is a line segment joining vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side. So here D is the midpoint of AB. So let CD be the median. Yes or no? And therefore D is the midpoint of AB. Okay, now if D is the midpoint of AB, so you can calculate the coordinates of point D using midpoint formula. So let us do that. Therefore, coordinates of point D will be given by x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, y is equal to y1 plus y2 by 2. Let us put the values. Therefore, x is equal to 3 plus 7 by 2 and y is equal to 4 minus 2 by 2. X is equal to 10 by 2, y is equal to 2 by 2. X is equal to 5 and y is equal to 1. And therefore, coordinates of D are 5, 1. So we got the coordinates of D to be 5, 1. Now we have to find the equation of CD. So now can we calculate the equation of CD? Yes. Now we have two points on line CD. We have the coordinates of the points C and D. So we can use the two-point formula. Yes or no? We have formula. So now we will write down. Therefore, equation of line passing through C minus 2 comma minus 1 and D 5 comma 1 is, okay, we will put the 2-point formula, that is y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Here coordinates of C will be x1, y1 and coordinates of D will be taken as x2, y2, and we will put the values in the formula. Okay, so let us put the values in the formula. Therefore, y minus minus 1, that is y plus 1 upon x plus 1, x plus 2, it is minus 2, so x plus 2 is equal to y2. What is y2 coordinates of D? Y coordinate, that is 1 plus 1 upon 5 plus 2. Therefore, y plus 1 upon x plus 2 is equal to 2 by 7. Therefore, 7y plus 7 is equal to 2x plus 4. equation required, answer the equation of median CD. So here the first part of question number 16 is over. X minus 7y minus 3. Now we will solve the second part. Okay, in the second part also we are given the vertices of triangle ABC, different vertices. Okay, and M is a point on AB such that the ratio AM is to MB is given. Let us write down the details first. Okay, second part of question number 16. Coordinates A, B, C of triangle ABC are given. A has the coordinates 2, 5. B has the coordinates -1, 2. And C has the coordinates 5, 8. These are the vertices of triangle ABC. M is a point on AB such that these are the vertices of triangle ABC. M is a point on line segment AB or side AB such that AM is to MB is 1:2. We have to find the coordinates of M and then the line passing through point C and A. Okay, let us draw the diagram once again. Okay, coordinates of C are given, coordinates of A are given, coordinates of B are given. M is a point on AB such that ratio AM is to MB is 1:2. Yes or no? AM is to MB is 1:2. We have to find the coordinates of M first. So how to proceed, tell me. How will you proceed? Obviously, in order to find the coordinates of M, we will use the section formula which we have done in the previous chapter, section and midpoint formula, yes or no? So we can say, since you are given x1, y1, x2, y2 and ratio M is to N is also given, so we can calculate the coordinates of M using the section formula. So we will do that. Okay, so here A 2, 5, x1, y1 and B -1, 2 will be x2, y2. Okay, ratio M is to N is given to be 1:2. Yes or no? So coordinates of M, coordinates of point M will be given by the formula x is equals to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and y is equals to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. Okay, now let us substitute the values. Therefore x is equals to value of m is 1 and n is 2. Okay, so mx2, that is 1 into -1 plus 2 into 2 upon 1 plus 2, and y is equals to 1 into 2 plus 2 into 5 upon 1 plus 2. Okay, now let us simplify. Okay, this is 2 into 5, 1 into 2 plus 2 into 5. Therefore x is equals to -1 plus 4 upon 3, and y is equals to 2 1s are 2 and 5 2s are 10. So 10 plus 2, 12 upon 3 and therefore x is equals to 3 upon 3 and y is equals to 4, x is equal to, or let me write down one step over here, 2 plus 10 by 3, so 12 by 3, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 4, and therefore we got the coordinates of n to be 1, 4. Here, so we got the coordinates of m. Now you are told to find the equation of a line passing through C and M. So obviously now you can calculate the equation of a line passing through C and M. How? So using 2-point formula, because we are given the coordinates of 2 points C and M on the required line. So we can use directly 2-point formula to find the equation of the line. Clear? Okay, so now let us write down the formula. Therefore, equation of line CM y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Okay, now x1, y1 coordinates of C and x2, y2 coordinates of M we can take, and we can put the value in the formula. Okay, now let us solve question number 17. Again, question number 17, the vertices of triangle ABC are given, A2, minus vertices of triangle ABC, we have to find the equations of the sides. It means we have to find the equations of the side AB, side BC and side AC respectively. So we have three sides. It means we have to find the equation of three lines. First we will find out the equation of line AB or side AB. Yes or no? Then of BC and then of AC. So in each case we will use the 2-point formula only. Direct application of formula. Okay, equation of line AB or side AB, what is the formula? Y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Okay, so x1 y1 coordinates of A and x2 y2 coordinates of B. Therefore, y plus 11 upon x minus 2 is equal to 13 plus 11 upon 2 minus 2. Okay, therefore, y plus 11 upon x minus 2 is equal to 13 means 24 upon 0. So, let us cross multiply. Okay, now since you look at this specific value, we are getting 24 upon 0. Actually, this is meaningless. It means this is undefined. But still, we are writing like this. We will cross multiply 0 with this number. So, this term on the left side will become 0. Yes or no? Clear? So, y plus 11, 0 into y plus 11 is equal to 24 into x minus 2. Okay, further, this term is undefined, so what does this term suggest? Or in other way, if you try to understand, what is this? The expression on the right hand side, you are familiar with this value, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. What is that? We know that this is the formula to calculate the slope. Okay, so this value on the right hand side gives us the slope of line AB. Okay, and here slope of line AB is 24 by 0 means undefined. So when the slope is undefined, if the line is parallel to y axis, clear? So in that way also you can consider. Yes or no? So here you will get the equation of the form any line parallel to y axis, x is equal to A. So let us see. 0 into y plus 11, 0 is equals to 24 into x minus 2. Therefore, x minus 2 is equal to 0 or x is equals to 2. So, this is the equation of line AB. Clear? Understood? So, don't get confused over here. Whenever you get 24 by 0, don't write over here 0, because 24 by 0 is not equal to 0, it is undefined, number 1. Okay, so you can cross multiply like this, then you will get the answer. Or this slope, when this value is 0, it means the slope is undefined. So obviously, the line AB is parallel to y axis, so you can consider any one point. Okay, and put the formula x is equal to A. Now, whether you take coordinate of A or coordinates of point B, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, in both the cases you will get the same equation. Obviously, you will get the same equation because A and B both are lying on the same line. Okay, so we have got the equation of line AB. Clear? So, I hope you have understood this concept. Okay, so remember this step. Clear? The particular questions. Okay, now we got the equation of AB. Now we will find out the equation of BC using the same formula. Equation of BC. Y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Every time 2-point formula, if you are given the coordinates of 2-point, then you should use the this formula directly. Okay, now in this case, coordinates of B will be x1, y1 and coordinates of C will be x2, y2. Or you can take the reverse. You can take even the coordinate of C to x1 y1, and coordinates of b2 x2 y2. So you can consider either of these two ways. Clear? So I am taking the coordinates of b as x1 y1 and coordinates of c as x2 y2, and therefore y minus 13 upon x minus 2 is equal to 1 minus 13 upon minus 12 minus 2. Let us simplify. Y minus 13 upon x minus 2 is equal to minus 12 upon minus 14. Okay, now let us further simplify. Okay, so y minus 13 upon x minus 2 is equal to reduce both the numerator and denominator by 2, so 6 by 7. Now cross multiply, so 7y minus 91 is equal to 6x minus 12. 7y minus 6x 91. 18 and 79 minus 79 is equal to 0, or 6x minus 7y plus 79 is equal to 0. This is equation of line segment BC. So far we got the equations of the two sides, side AB and side BC. Now we have to still calculate the equation of line or side AC. Question number 17. 7y minus 6x. Yes. Okay, now let us calculate the equation of AC. Okay, so equation of AC again will be given by y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Remember that every time if you don't write the formula, it will do. Once in the beginning we have written, in the further steps you can directly put the values. Okay, now AC, coordinates of A I will take to be x1 y1 and coordinates of C to be x2 y2. Therefore y plus 11 upon x minus 2 is equal to 1 plus 11 upon minus 12 minus 2. Y plus 11 upon x minus 2 is equal to 12 by minus 14. Therefore, y plus 11 upon x minus 2 is equal to 6 upon minus 7. Therefore, minus 7y minus 77 is equal to 6x minus 12. Therefore, minus 7y minus 6x plus minus 65 is equal to 0. Or 6x plus 7y plus 65 is equal to 0. This is the equation of line AC. 6x plus 7y plus 65 is equal to 0. Okay, this is the equation of line AC. So we have got the equations of three sides, respectively AB, BC and AC. Question number 17, 6x plus 7y plus 65. So today, starting from question number 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, we could solve 6 questions in this video. Further questions we will solve in the next video. Yes or no? This topic is totally new to you, you need to practice again and again. Yes or no? So practice is the only thing which will make you perfect. Okay, the first and the important thing is to remember the concepts of this chapter, as well as the formulas, different forms of lines. formula of slope, formula of various forms of lines, yes or no? What is x-intercept, what is y-intercept, these all things must be very clear. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask me anytime. Thank you very much.